Adriano Moraes made a great comment. He said, while Demetrius Johnson was dominating the UFC, I was dominating one championship. He was king of the East, Demetrius is king of the West. And now the two kings collide to decide who is truly the champ.
Throws a knee to the jaw, DJ's hurt, it's good night, Irene!
If you know, you know. If you didn't, you know now. It's not a shock to Adriano. It's not a shock to those that have seen him dominate one championship over the last few years.
With a single grounded knee, one flyweight world champion, Adriano Moraes, became the first man to finish MMA icon Demetrius Johnson. It was a strike legal only in the circle, but Mighty Mouse refused to make excuses.
I believe in these rules. I believe they've been put into place for a reason. And it's just a different aspect of the game that you have to go to evolve around. If the roles were reversed, I would have blasted his too.
On August 26th, these superstars will collide once again in the main event of ONE on Prime Video ONE. And ahead of his rematch with Moraes, Mighty Mouse turned to old rivals and new teachers alike.
I just got to finish up 2 weeks at Arizona with Henry Cejudo and his team. It was good. It was a fun time training, mixing it up with him. He's a legend, gold medalist wrestler, two divisional champion. I started training back in the gi in jiu-jitsu. Found an amazing professor, Professor Yan, down at Sumner Grapple Club. And honestly, that's been a breath of fresh air. In my past training camps, I've always focused on my strength and conditioning. I have gotten stronger, but I'm like, you know what? Why don't we take away from my strength and conditioning, because I'm always in great shape and actually put more to my craft, which is mixed martial arts, which is fighting. It's almost given me new life and to look at things at a different perspective.
But greatness also defines Moraes, who owns the most wins, finishes, and submissions in ONE flyweight history.
I don't care who you're gonna train, I will be there with 100% to finish him. I got more light on me. The fans turn their eyes more for my job and they follow me more constantly. But by myself, nothing changed. I just keep it doing what I always doing, like training, provide fun to my family, help my friends, my brothers, and keep on working. I don't think so I have something to prove anymore. I've been dominating this division for a long time. But of course, by myself, I always like to challenge myself and I'm trying to display the best my MMA game plan.
In March, Johnson submitted ONE flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rod Tangjit Muangnon, in a special rules super fight. An experience he hopes to use against Moraes.
The Rod Tang fight was dope. It was a great camp. We spent a lot of time on Muay Thai. My sweeps got really freaking good. I love that pressure because he brings the fight. That's the same thing how I want to fight. I always go forward. Adriano, he's a phenomenal athlete, but when I watched on camera, it's exactly what I felt in the cage, which was how much he used movement to avoid fighting. Like if somebody's running like this, they're avoiding the confrontation of the fight. It's a good skill set that's got him where he is today. For me, it's just not my cup of tea.
I don't agree. You can see my numbers. The most finish, the most fights, and the most title defenses in the flyweight division.
This isn't the first time I had to fight someone who likes to use footwork and angles. Dominic Cruz, John Dodson, Kyoji Horiguchi, and even those fights, I got impatient. It's just amplified because I was able to get finished from my impatience. So for me, I just gotta find that fine line of being patient and being super aggressive.
It's our main event, the rematch the world's been waiting for.
I'm just here writing my story, writing my legacy. DJ is the GOAT, the greatest of all time. He has the numbers. Winning this fight will help a lot on my legacy. And maybe I would be in the Hall of Fame of ONE Championship one day.
When it comes to the whole GOAT talk, how would the people say that? If somebody says, man, how good were you? I'm like, I was one of the best to do it. There's nobody out there who had a clinch like me. There's nobody out there who could transition like I could. There's nobody out there who could push the pace like I could. I haven't met another person out there who can do it like me. When you find somebody like that, be consistent over 6 years, holla at me.
Yes, he's the best. He's the guy, and I beat him.
Oh!
I will finish him with submission.
I don't look at get wins back. Unless you got a time traveling machine, it happened, you move forward, you look fresh to a new beginning, and going out there and try to put this man away.